morning, Brian. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. It is an honor to be able to do the devotion today. Today I will be reading Daniel chapter 10, 18 through 19. And it reads, "Again, the one who looks like a man touched me and gave me strength. Do not be afraid. You who are highly esteemed," he said, "peace, be strong now, be strong." When he spoke to me, I was strengthened and said, "Speak, my Lord, since you have given me strength." I will be reading from the New Testament, Hebrews chapter 10, verses 36 through 39. You need to persevere. So when you have done the will of God, you will receive what he has promised. For in just a little while, he who is coming will come and will not delay. But my righteous one will live by faith, and I take no pleasure in the one who shrinks back. But he do not belong to those who shrink back and are destroyed, but to those who have faith and are saved.
Amen. Our Father, our Lord, my God, we come humbly before you this morning, God, to bless your holy name. We acknowledge you as our refuge and our strength, O God, our banner and our fortress, Lord. God, we honor you this morning. We thank you for everything that you've done for us, God. We know, Lord, that we haven't been the best servants, God. We haven't been the best parents, God. We haven't been the best members, God, of your church, God. We haven't been the best people, God, that you've called us to be, Father. But we ask you this morning, God, for your forgiveness, God. We ask, Lord, that you turn your head from our sins, God. Don't look up on our sins, God, but look up on our hearts, God. Look and see, Father, who we really are, God, your children, God. Lord, we are saved by your grace, God, and we thank you, Lord, for your grace this morning, God. Lord, we confess that we have not been everything, God, that you've called us to be, Father. God, we ask for your forgiveness today, God. Lord, we know that we are sinners saved by grace, God. Peace, God, and we thank you for your mercy, God. Lord, we thank you for being such a good God to us, Lord. Lord, during these hard times, God, in these troubling days, God, we thank you, God, for being our strength, God. We thank you, Lord, for being our song, oh God. Lord, we thank you for being our strong tower, God. Thank you, Lord, for being our healer, God, and our protector, God. Thank you for being our provider, God. Lord, when we think that we don't have enough, God, we always have enough, God. We thank you, God, for being such a great God. Lord, we thank you for being so merciful, God. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for forgiving us of our sins, God. We know, God, that there are many times, God, that we're not worthy, God, to even be called a child of God. God, but you look past our faults, God, and you see our needs, God, and we thank you, God, so much, Lord, for your grace, God. Lord, we thank you for bringing us out into a spacious place, God. We thank you, Lord, for rescuing us from things and situations, God, that we've gone through in our lives, God. We thank you, Lord, for being our everything, oh God. Lord, we thank you this morning, God, that you're going to crown our pastor with your wisdom, Lord, as he brings your word, God. Lord, just give him tongues of fire, God, and prepare our hearts, God, to receive the word that you have planted on the inside of him, God. Lord, open our minds and our hearts to receive it, oh God. Lord, we thank you for everything that you've done for us, God, everything that you're about to do, God. Lord, we thank you for what you're doing in this earth, oh God. Lord, other people may not see your word, God, but we see your word, God, and we are grateful, God, for everything that you've done. Lord, we ask that you just continue to keep your hand upon us, God. Lord, continue to watch over us and keep us, oh God. Continue to keep us healthy, God, and strengthen our bodies, oh God. Strengthen our minds, Lord. Touch our spirits, oh God. that we may continue to walk strong and circumspectly, God, in the presence of those that are around us, God. Lord, let people see Christ in us, God. Don't let them see us, God, but let us see Christ in us, Lord. Lord, let people run to your altars and ask, what must they do to be saved, oh God? Lord, let them see your work. Begin to see your work on this earth, God. Lord, we thank you so much for everything that you've done, God. We thank you, Lord, that you are keeping us and protecting us, God. We thank you, God, for this morning, God. We thank you that the word is going to be rich, God, and that we may be able to apply it to our lives. We bless your holy name this morning, God. We thank you for everything, God. And we ask in all these blessings in Jesus' name. Amen.
Your grace and mercy brought me through. I'm living this moment because of you. I want to thank you and praise you too. Your grace and mercy brought me through. It was because grace and mercy came along.
Now, for our news, updates, and events, please recite our mission statement with me. We engage ourselves to proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ in both voice and vitality, to the extent that all believers would experience spiritual maturity and further expand this same ministry of the kingdom and mission of God's grace to the masses. Happy birthday, Jada Freeman, December 5th. Congratulations to Dr. Alicia D. Babin on accomplishing a doctoral degree in educational leadership. We are so proud of you. E-giving through Giveify is our number one option for giving. Please remember to press the green button. Our second option is giving by drop-off. Please remember to attend at the times provided. Option three is giving by mail. Please use the P.O. box listed. Please subscribe to our YouTube page, Berean Tabernacle BC. Our website can be reached at www.BereanTabernacle.co. Upcoming events. Church leaders will meet with Pastor via Zoom at 6:30, December 16th. December 25th, we will have Christmas worship at 10 a.m. Youth Bible study and Pastor's Bible study will resume January 2021. This has been your news, updates, and events. May God bless and keep you.
Be blessed, my brother. Be blessed, my sister. Be blessed wherever this life leads you. Let me encourage you. Let me speak life to you. You can depend on God to see it through.
Somebody tonight, all of the hurt and the pain that you've gone through, God's got an answer for you tonight. You might be hurting,
you might be crying,
you might be worrying.
You can depend on me
to pray for you.
Praise God. Hello, Berean. It's a good day to serve the Lord today. We just thank God for his goodness and for his tender mercy, for his loving kindness. He's been so good to us. And we just want to give him some praise today. I thank God for Dr. Clayton and Dr. Hurley Clayton and Dr. Margie Clayton, all the deacons and all the ministers and members of Berean and family and friends, any that might be listening today. I thank God for the opportunity just to bring a word, a short word this morning. Actually, that if you're praying with me and if we just pray, God is going to get us through this. And I feel like God has a word for somebody to encourage somebody today to make a difference in somebody's life. And I just thank God today. So this morning, if you have your Bibles, we're going to go to Matthew 11:28. Amen. 28 and 29 in the NIV. Amen. Amen. And just talking on God lightening our burdens, God carrying our burdens this morning. My burdens are light. Amen. My burdens are light. And it says Matthew 11:28 reads, it says, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon me and learn from me. For I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls." Amen. Have you ever just been so tired? Just tired. You know, there are times that I've been so tired that I could feel my head hitting the pillow before it even hit. I could feel myself just walking and just diving in my bed or diving on my couch. I could just feel myself. It wasn't there, but I could just feel it because I was just so tired. You could just see yourself just stretched out. And sometimes your body look like your body is one place and your mind somewhere else because you're just so tired. Sometimes you feel like the people on the walking dead, you're just walking around like a zombie in days because you're just so tired. Well, you know, sometimes life circumstances itself can cause us to be weighed down and we're so tired of what we're going to. I do my little devotional every day on Facebook and a lot of friends at work and people, and you hear people talking in the store and everybody say, "I'm just tired. I'm tired of this COVID virus. I'm tired of 2020. And they're just tired. And we're tired of losing loved ones. I've lost a loved one this week. I've lost a student this week from the COVID virus. And people said that they're just tired of people dying and losing their jobs and tired of people being in the food line and people living in their cars and people under the bridge. And the government they're tired of the government and the politicians because they seem like they're all confused, tired of the division in the world and look like the crime rate is up and they just tired. Because it's just so much going on. And so look like the word that everybody using is "I'm tired." But they're tired and they're asking God, is there going to be a change? Is things going to get different? You know, but I come to encourage you this morning and to come to let you know that there is some relief on the way, that God has an answer. And it seems like life has put a yoke around our neck, that there's a yoke around our neck. And you know, the Bible speaks of that yoke being, and they said that a yoke is a wooden frame that was used to put two ox together and they would pull the weight and they would pull that load. But the thing about it is that when we give our life to Jesus and when we give our burdens and our weights to Jesus, he lightens up our heavy load. He lightens up the load. A lot of times we're carrying stuff that we shouldn't be carrying. Amen. But Jesus is on our side. Praise God. And he's lighting up the load. He's lighting up the load of the yokes that we're dealing with in life and the things that we're carrying, and the weights, the burdens and everything. And the thing about weights and being tired, there are different types of, there's four different type of tired I want to talk about today. Okay. I'm just going to take my time. Physical tired, emotional tired, financial tired, and being spiritually tired, being physically tired, being emotionally tired, financially tired, and spiritually tired. When we're physically tired, our countenance, it shows up on our face. People can look at us and we say, "Oh girl, you look so tired. You are right." And people can see it. And then sometimes it shows up in your appearance. You don't even want to comb your hair. You don't care how you dress. You just, cause you're just tired. You put anything on, It shows in your walk. You're walking sluggish. You're walking lazy. It even shows up in your service, shows up on your job, on the work, on your performance. And it shows up in the church, on your worship. You know, we singing a song and we singing like, oh, woke up this morning with my mind. And we barely, there's no spirit in it. There's nothing in it because we're tired. We are physically tired. But in Proverbs 17:22 says, I'm going to be using a lot of scriptures today. It says, a cheerful heart is one of my Uncle Toby's, Brother Deacon Toby's favorite scriptures. He always says it all the time. It says, a cheerful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones. That when your spirit is crushed, it feels like your bones is all dried up. But a cheerful heart is good medicine for your body, for your bones, physical. Amen? And then we look at emotional tide. We drain emotionally, not able to move forward. We're just weak, dealing with life itself, tired of weak, holding on to past hurts, holding on to things and carrying weights and things that we shouldn't even be carrying. That's a particular story of 2 months. It was a young month and an old month. Y'all know I like my stories, y'all. Y'all know I like my stories. There was an older monk and a young monk, and they was on their way to the monastery. And if you know anything about monks, they don't have any dealings with women. They're not supposed to touch them and really not even supposed to look at them, you know, because they're monks. And as they was on their way to the monastery, they got to the river, and that was a little shallow river. And to get across to go to the monastery, you have to cross the river. And there was a young lady standing there with her wedding dress on, and she was crying because she was trying to get to the other side. And the only way she was going to get to the other side if somebody helped her or carried her. So without saying a word, the old monk picked her up, put her around his neck and walked to the other side and put her down on the other side and continued to the monastery. And on the way there, the young monk was saying, what are you doing? You know, we're not supposed to have no dinners with no ladies. We're not even supposed to touch no ladies. You know, what are you doing? And the older monk didn't say nothing. So they went to sleep and through the night. They woke up the next morning and the young monk said, I can't believe you carried that you pick up that young lady and carried her. And he said, you mean to tell me you went to sleep all night carrying that weight? When I put her down on the other side of the river, I put that weight down. A lot of times there's stuff that we carry. We carry it all through the night. We carry it for years. We carry it for months. We carry stuff that we shouldn't be carrying. When all we have to do is put it down and give it to Jesus, we carrying stuff that we shouldn't be carrying. So that's a lot of time. That's why we are emotionally tired, because we're caring, we're holding on to stuff that we shouldn't be holding on to. In James 1 and 2, it says, consider it pure joy, my brother and sister, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Amen. So our trials, the Bible says the trials come to make us strong. We can't be holding on to this stuff and carrying stuff that we shouldn't be carrying. That's why a lot of times we end up tired. And then there's one that's financially tired. You know, we're working from paycheck to paycheck, paying Peter, robbing Peter and paying Paul. And then after we pay Paul, there's Jack standing with his hand out. You know, we're working for, I can't see the don't see, I wish I could see. But because we're financially tired. But in Philippians 4:19, y'all know what it says. It says, my God, and my God would meet all our needs according to his riches and glory in Christ Jesus. God will supply all your needs, not your wants, but your needs. A lot of time, you know, we want certain things. A lot of times, Cody say, mommy, I'm hungry. I'm hungry. I'm saying, well, go in the kitchen, find something to eat. There's something in there. There's noodles. There's something in there. But I don't want that. What you mean you don't want that? You said you're hungry. If you're hungry, you're going to eat what I have. A lot of times, you want to go uptown and buy something. And that's how it is with us with God. We want something. We need something, but we want something. What do I mean? God's going to supply the need, but a lot of times, we don't want what God's given us. We want something different. You need to be careful. Listen to what I'm saying. You need to be careful how we refuse what God is trying to give us, because all God is trying to do is meet the need. There are times he meets the wants, but he wants to supply our needs. Amen. And then there's spiritually tired. Spiritually tired. That's when our joy is gone. Our peace is gone. We're ready to give up. We're weary. We're tired. Our commitment is gone. Our dedication is gone. It all has gone. Seems like the life has been sucked out of us because we are spiritually tired, spiritually tired. Psalm 73:26 reads, it says, my flesh and my heart may fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. Amen. God has given us the strength that we need. The songwriter said that God is one of my favorite songs. God, Dr. Doc sung a couple of months back when we was in church, and well, she just don't know that song. I just could have took that mic and just ran up and down the aisle because it was saying who God was. It said that God is the joy of my strength. He moves all pain and misery and strife. He promised to keep me, never to leave you. He says never come short of his word. Says that I gotta fast and pray, stay in the narrow way, keep my life clean every day. Says that I want to go with him when he come back. And it says that I come too far. You need to tell yourself, I've come too far and I never turn back. Why? Because God is my strength. Even with all the burdens that we carry, God is our strength. We just have to be committed to the call. We have to trust God. We have to fast and pray and believe that God is going to get us through this, that things is going to get better. I don't care what it look like, what it feel like. God has given us strength. In Romans 8:26, it says, in the same way, the Spirit help us in our weakness. We do not know what we ought to pray, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us through wordless groans. You know, the old folks used to say that when you groan, the devil don't know what you're talking about. Well, sometimes you might can't say nothing. Sometimes we so burdened down, weighed down, stressed, depressed, till we can't say nothing. We can't do nothing but groan. But it says that the Spirit intercedes for us. You know, when we was in service, the prayer wars, Minister Della and Brother Toby and Brother Henry and Deacon Lewis and Sister Gail Ozan and so many of them would go on Saturday mornings or sometime before church on Sunday mornings, and they would pray and they would intercede for the church, and they would intercede for people and interceding and praying. They would get the prayers out of the prayer bucket, and they would pray and they was interceding for others. Well, it says that the Spirit intercede for us in our weakness, that when we weak, when you can't pray, when you can't say nothing, sometimes all you can say is just Jesus. Sometimes all you can just say is help me, Lord. And sometimes all you can do is just groan. But the Spirit intercedes for us. Praise God. In Isaiah 40:29, he said, he gives strength to the weary and increases the power. He gives strength to the weary, increase the power of the weak. Even the youth grow weary and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagle. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. Amen. Said those that hope. What is hope? Hope is when you're expecting for God to move. It's when you're expecting something. When you say, ooh, I hope things gonna get better. Ooh, I hope this gonna turn around. Hope is when you're being certain that God, hope is when you're being certain that what you believe is gonna happen, what you believe. That's what hope is. Hope is knowing that God is going to do what God says he's going to do. You're just hoping because you know that it's on the way. You're expecting it. You're expecting for God to move. You're expecting for God to ease up this burden. You're expecting for God to ease up this load. You're expecting for God to give us strength. And say that those that run won't get weary. Now, look, I can't run like I used to run. So if I run right now, I'm going to get weary. But in the spiritual realm, the running that we're doing, we might get weary, but God's going to give us strength. And it said they might walk and they won't faint. It said that we might run and we won't grow weary. We won't grow weary. We're running for Jesus and we won't grow weary. The old folks, you said, I'm running for Jesus and I'm not tired yet. Why was they saying it? They said, because I'm running in the spiritual realm, because I know that I'm running, but Jesus is with me. What is he doing? He's yoked up with me. Amen. Praise God. Then it said that those that will walk, they won't faint. In other words, they're not going to fall. They're not going to fall. It might look like we're falling. We might lean a little bit. We might bend a little bit, but we're not going to fall when we're yoked up with Jesus. Amen. Praise God. Jesus knows and he understands our times of weakness and that we're tired and we're worn out and we're wore out. But he's been through the same test. Matter of fact, he's been tested. He's been through more stuff than we've ever been through because he went to the cross for us. He's been tested and he did not sin. He was tested on every side. Jesus was tested for us, and he didn't bend, and he didn't sin. In Hebrews, I told you I was using scriptures. I was going to use scriptures today. Hebrews 4:15 says, for we do not have a high priest when is unable to empathize with our weakness. that he's not able to understand what we're going through. It said, but we have one who has been tempted in every way, just as we are, yet he did not sin. He did not sin. So sometimes we think that we're the only one that's going through. Excuse me, y'all. We think that we're the only one going through. Why am I going through this? Why me, Lord? How come we don't ever? How come us? We the only one? No, you're not. Why am I going through this? When is things going to change, turn? When is things going? You're not the only one. The thing is right now, if you look around and if you see, we're all going through some type of struggle. We're all going through some type of hardship. Everybody right now is going through something. There's some type of something that some of us that got are tired because some of the things that we're going through. But thank God for Jesus that he is making our burdens a little light. You're not the only one that's struggling. You're not the only one that's going through. You're not the only one that's losing loved ones and people losing jobs and family members losing jobs. And you're trying to help each other, trying to pass some sugar over here and some flour over here and a chicken over here and a bread over here to make sure that we all eating and putting pennies together to pay this bill and pay this bill and giving this one little gas money and getting a little gas money. You're not the only one. We're all going through. But thank God that Jesus is with us, making that burden a little lighter. Amen. Oh, if I was in church right now, I'll tell you to put your hands together, give God some praise, because thank God for Jesus. Amen. Because Jesus went through everything. But the thing about it is that Jesus overcame everything that we're dealing with. Jesus went through and overcame. He went through it and he overcame and he came out with all power. And he's given us that same power. He's given us that same power. You have to know what you have. We have to know what we have, what has been given to us. In John 16, it says, 16 to 38, it says, I have told you these things so that in me you might have peace. In me, in Jesus, in who? In me, you might have what? Peace, that in this world, you're going to have what? Trouble. You're going to have what? Burdens. You're going to have what? Weights. You're going to have problems and disappointment and mishap and discouragement. You're going to have all of this. But he says what? Cheer up. Take heart. Cheer up. I have overcome the world. What is he saying? Overcome it. I got the victory in this thing. If I got the victory in it, you got the victory in it. Matthew 26 and 38 really says, and when Jesus got ready to go to the Gethsemane, now I'm talking about the garden right now. When he was in the garden, Jesus had some weights. I'm sure he got tired, but in the garden, he said, Matthew 26, 38, he says, then he said to them, my soul is overwhelmed. My soul is overwhelmed. My soul is weighed down. My soul, I'm tired. I'm burdened with sorrow to the point of death. He said, stay here and keep watch with me. Sometime when we're going through something, we need some folks. Sometimes folks ain't on. Sometimes we need somebody on our side praying with us. You got to tell them, I'm so overwhelmed. I got so much going on. Can you just pray with me? I need somebody to intercede for me. I need somebody praying for me. Jesus, the disciples, he didn't have nobody at that time. He said, could y'all just watch a few minutes while I go? Can you just pray with me? Because I'm so overwhelmed. And then in Matthew 26, 42, it says, after he then went back to the Father two and three times, to the third time, he said, my Father, if it is not possible for this cup to be taken, if it's not possible for this burden to be taken, if it's not possible for this weight to be taken, nevertheless, in other words, if it's not possible for this cup to be taken away unless I drink it, may your will be done. In other words, Father, if this is what you want me to do, if this is what you want me to go through, I'm going to go through it. And sometimes you got to realize that there's some stuff that we're going to go through. We're going to go through burdens. We're going to go through trials. We're going to go feel like time, like when we're weary and weak, when we feel like giving up. But you can't give up. You got to know that Jesus is with us. He's lighting up the burden. He's lighting up the burden. Amen. And I know he lightened up the burden because Jesus went, we said that Jesus went to the cross. When he went to the cross, he went to the cross. And they hung him. He was hung. He hung, bled, and died. He went to the cross. He went to the grave. They put him in a tomb. And then after 3 days, he's got up with all power. And if he got up with power, we can get up with that same power. What he did on the cross, he gave us the power that we need to be able to go through what we're going through right now. Praise God. Sometimes it doesn't look good for the home team. Sometimes it don't look good for the saints. Sometimes it don't look good for the church. Sometimes it don't look good for us. But I come to encourage you today. Ah, my mind, that if you just keep trusting and believing, if you just put your faith in God, God is getting ready to turn this thing around. I come to encourage you. Encourage you. And sometimes when you're weighed down and burdened, just like Jesus didn't have the disciples then fell asleep on and wouldn't pray, sometimes you got to encourage your own self. Sometimes, I said this week in one of my devotions, sometimes you got to pat your own self on the back. Pick your own self up. Dust your own self off. Tell your own self, it's going to be all right. Jesus is lighting up my burden. Sometimes you got to encourage your own self. Praise God. Because Jesus is lighting up my burden. In James 1 and 12, it said, blessed is the one who persevere under trials, because having stood the test, that person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him. Praise God. You just got to keep on pushing. That in the end, you're going to get your reward. You just got to keep going. We just got to keep going, regardless how stressful, my God, regardless how you might be depressed or burdened down, and maybe you just don't know what to do. Maybe you're at that point where you just don't know what to do, that you're so weighed down that you can't pray, You don't want to talk to nobody. You don't want to be you don't want to be bothered with nobody. The spirit of depression has came in and is weighing you down. You're tired. You're worn out. You're drained. But Jesus said that he'll give us rest. He's lifting up that yoke. He's taking that yoke. He's lifting it up. He's taking that yoke off our neck. And he's carrying that burden for us. Praise God. Rest means rest. When we say rest, rest means to seek from work for or from movement, just to rest. Sometimes we just got to sit still and rest in order to relax. And the thing is, God will recover. That when we're resting, God recovers and he strengthens us. Praise God. That when we resting in us, that when we resting in him, praise God, Lord is refreshing us. He's refreshing. Have you ever been so thirsty? Every now and then you see him get a little sip of water. But if somebody's exercising or they're running or they're working hard and they need a cool drink of water or a cool shower, and after they get that cool water and that cool shower, they say, ooh, that refreshed me so, because I was just so tired. But that's what Jesus is doing for us. He's refreshing. Not only is he refreshing, but he's renewing our strength. Not only is he renewing our strength, he restoring our joy and restoring our peace, and he restoring everything that we feel like we have lost. Praise God. He's lightening up our burdens. He's lightening them. We just got to learn how to trust God. We just got to learn how to go through. And we got to know that this too shall pass. We just got to believe in his word, and we got to rest in him. Pastors say sometimes that you got to know in your knowing. Ah. You got to know in your knowing that everything is going to be all right. You got to know in your knowing that God is going to turn this thing around. You got to know in your knowing that God's favor is on us. You got to know in your knowing that Jesus is lighting up this burden. You just got to know it for yourself. You ain't got to have nobody to tell you. You just got to know it for yourself. You done read the word. You done prayed. You done fasted. But because of what we go through sometimes we so burdened out, we forget what the word says. Praise God. But you got to know it. Got to know it for yourself. God is getting ready to turn this thing up without a shadow of a doubt. I know it in my spirit. It might not look good for the hard team. It might look kind of hard and bleak right now. It might be dark and gloom in this world right now. But I come to encourage you today that Jesus is going to lighten it up, our burden. He's going to turn it around. God is getting ready to work some miracles in our life. Getting ready. And so this is not the time to give up. It's not the time to throw up your hands and say I'm tired. This is not the time to take the towel and throw in the white flag and saying that I surrender. This is not the time. This is the time to hold on to that rope. And when that rope slips, you tie a knot. And when that knot fall a piece or loosen up, you tie another knot, and then you tie, and then you keep on tying knot till you get to the top of that rope, and you just got to hold on, and you just got to keep fasting, and you just got to keep praying, and you just got to keep believing, and you just got to know. Nehemiah 8 says that the joy of the Lord is my strength. Maybe you need some strength today. You got to know that the joy of the Lord is your strength. He's going to get us through this in due season. Don't get tired of doing what you're doing. You just got to keep on doing what you're doing. You got to, because the Bible said, don't get tired of doing what you're doing. What are you doing right now? Are you fasting? Are you praying? Are you trusting God? Are you doing what you can for others? Are you standing in your word? Are you standing before God? Are you standing in the gap that's saying that for God I live, for God I die? I don't care what it look like. I don't care if I eat another plate of food. I don't care if I don't have no lights, no water. I don't care if I don't have no money in my pocket. For God I live, for God I die. I know that God is going to turn it around. I put my faith, I put my trust in him because I know that he's able. You got to know that if you keep doing what you're doing in due time, the harvest is coming. What is the harvest? The harvest is the blessing. The harvest of God is when God opened up the windows of heaven. God is the harvest is when God opened doors that have been shut in your face. What is the harvest? The harvest is that load bitten lighter. Jesus taking that burden for us. So you can't get tired right now. This is not the time to give up. It's not time to give in, saints. It's time for us to press our way. It's time to pray harder than we never prayed before. It's time to trust God like we never trusted him before. It's time to believe like we never believed before. It's time to live and serve God like we never served him before. You can't get tired. You can't get tired. You just got to praise your way. You just got to praise your way through it. Got to praise your way through it. Says that praise is what I do when I want to be close to you. Said that I lift my hands and praise. Praise is what I do. And sometimes you just gotta praise your way in the situation. You just gotta praise your way. Said that I vow to praise you. Because praise is whatever I go through, God, I just come to praise you tonight. I just come to praise you this morning. I praise you in the noonday. Praise you in the morning. Praise you at nighttime. Whatever the time of the day, I just come to praise you. And you wake up in the morning, start praising. Lunchtime, start praising him. Noonday, afternoon, start praising. When you're late, praise him. We got to praise our way through this. And we got to trust God that God is going to get us through this. And you just got to lift up your hands and sometime and say, God, I need you. Lord, I need you, Lord. Lord, we need you right now. We need you like never before. We need you, Lord. Need you. Need you. I just feel this in my spirit that, Lord, I need you. Y'all know me. I just gotta sing a little something. I need you. I need thee. Oh, I need thee. Every hour I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. Lord, I come to thee, I pray, because I need thee. I pray, because I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. Lord, I come to thee. Maybe that's you tonight, today, this morning, that you just need him. You need the Lord today. You need him. Maybe you've been going through, and maybe you're the one that I'm talking to today that's tired, that just wore out, and you're ready to give up. But I come to let you know that if you give it to Jesus, if you give your life to Jesus, if you give your situation to Jesus, he'll make it light. If you give your life to him, he's standing there with his arms wide open. Just give it to him. Give it to him. Berean is a good place to be. Berean is a good place where the word, where our pastor is giving us the word and the teaching of the Lord is going forth. So maybe that's you this morning that want to give your life to Jesus. And you can do that. That if you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus died and God raised him from the dead, you will be saved today. Amen. You will be saved. And I thank God today that maybe that was something that I said. Maybe something that'll help you to give your burdens to Jesus. Maybe something that'll lift up the weights. And I just believe that God is going to turn this thing around. It's not the time to give up. It's not the time to give in. It's time to hold on. And it's time to trust God. We give you praise. And God, we just give you glory. And we're just going to close in prayer. Father God, we thank you. And we love you. And we honor you. We thank you right now, God, that you're lighting these burdens for us. We thank you for giving your son, Jesus, who died on the cross for us, that our burdens are light. And Lord, whatever that your people is going through today, let them know that you're there for them. Let them know that you can turn their situation around. Let them know that you never have left them and you will never leave them. Let them know that you said in your word that there's nothing too hard for you. Let them know that you said in your word that as all things are possible to those that believe. And Father, we believe by faith right now in the name of Jesus. We thank you right now. We thank you for your word. We thank you that somebody might have been saved, healed, set free, or delivered. We thank you that maybe somebody's life was changed. God, we thank you for this opportunity. And it is in Jesus' name we pray. The mighty name of Jesus we pray. God, we love you. Amen. Praise God. Be blessed today. Amen.